with the roof cut out, with two sunroofs, and a glass floor on the one so I can see straight through to the sun. I mean, it's funny. Yo, hip-hop, it's funny we have these conversations because it's so American and it's hilarious. It's like, it is so ingrained in capitalism and what we do. Our entire culture, American culture, is based on turning nothing into something. You know, we appeared on this land and it's like, okay, it's mine now. And now I'm gonna make it, you know, what I can. So it's like, Soulja Boy to me is such a hip-hop story. And people are like, oh, what are you talking about? But, you know, the kid made a record in his bedroom and then got his homies to do a dance together and got there and pushed it any way he could and became the biggest thing in America. And it's like, what's more hip-hop than that? You know, like, that's what it is. It's saying, you know, what you guys are doing up here in terms of the status quo, which hip-hop is right now, is cool, but this is what I represent. This is what works for me. This is what comes from my area. And, you know, the counterculture is always going to figure out a way to upseat what the status quo is. So when it comes to the whole people are in it for the money, look, I'm three albums in. Like, if you're doing this just for the money, you're a stupid person. Because getting in and getting to the top of this game is probably harder than any other industry or any other sport, you know, that there is out there. I mean, I'm an Olympian. I ran in Athens in 2004, and I know how difficult that is. And it's way harder to get here than it is to even get to kind of the top of the echelon there. So the people, they may project a certain thing, and that's what I've realized. You talk to these people, and they project a certain persona that they feel they need to be. But they're still hip-hop heads at heart. They still love when nobody's around and a beat comes on, they're writing to it. You know, there still is that in them. Whether or not they realize it is one thing, but there's still that at the end of the day. So I never can take anything away from people, because to get here, the grind that you have to get to the top is so intense and so insane that once you get there, it's just like, you know, you busted your ass to get there. I can never take that away from you. So, I don't know. I never really worry about whether they do it for either or. Because if they make it, they definitely put in the work.
What was the question? No, that's good. Personally, I think music itself, we're here, we're products. You know what I mean? And we can be sold. The things that we do, we can't be sold to consumers. Right. That's why we study so hard and we go into the booth every day, because we're trying to get to an end to create another end, a better future. You know what I'm saying? For ourselves and people around us. So at the end of the day, we're all products and it can be sold and people buy it. So I don't think it's really, nobody should be blamed for creating a product that's being sold. You know what I mean? It's not a blame, it's not a bad thing, you know, like he said about Soulja Boy, whoever has good or bad music, if it's bad, don't listen to it. You know what I mean? It's as simple as that. It's not, I don't think it's really, let's see. Hip hop sells, you know what I mean? It always will sell. You know what I mean? So that's pretty much it.
Okay. And building on that, I personally think that it's the media and the outsiders of hip hop that's like they have us the underground versus the overground or the mainstream. Like you have these, it's almost like these two worlds. But a lot of us not only sit in both, but want to be in both. You know, you want to still be connected to the underground where you came from, but you also want to be able to go overseas and go tour all around. So, I guess what I'm saying is, especially with you all, the kids in the hall, what is going to take you from being just considered an underground artist to an overground artist, a mainstream artist? Is it, I mean, we know it's the hustle, but can you talk about that a little bit? Like going from this underground where you're doing shows, there's nobody coming, and all of a sudden you can see these building blocks building. And a lot of times, the underground, the people who haven't made it, want to try to make, you know, crossing over or mainstream a bad word, but I mean, that's just people who are not really into music might look at that way, but just kind of talk about the mainstream versus the underground.
I think just with me learning, you know, with Strong Arm, like, just to give an example, last year, Stanza was just making music by himself, you know what I mean? I was just, you know, in the studio, in the booth, like, rapping to the wall on the mic, you know what I mean? And put my little music on the internet, doing little shows here and there. And I stopped for a little while, you know? And then in that stoppage, I came to meet Fort Knox and Big Ty. Well, I had already met Knox, but I met Big Ty, Strong Arm, and now, what they tried to instill in me and what I didn't understand at first, I understood it, but, you know, it takes a hard-headed person a while to conceive, you know what I'm saying? They always preached to me consistency, you know what I mean? If you want to make it, if you can have the worst song in the history, if you're consistent with it and you are, this is what you want to happen, and you believe in it, it'll happen. People like bad music every day, you know what I mean? So I think that's the stepping stone, the consistency of it.
And or, you know, something equivalent. I think at this point, you know, we've done everything that you can do as an indie artist. You know, but there's the gap always happens in the sense that, yeah, we may make the greatest record, and, you know, but you need X amount of money to go to radio with it. You need X amount of money to, you know, really promote it and push it the way that you want to. And those things don't happen in the indie space. You know, they just don't have that money. So it's having that right team. I mean, major labels know how to make superstars, is what they do every day. So in order for a lot of acts to cross over, that's kind of where they have to be. I mean, if you look at it, there's no one music artist that's done it without, you know. I mean, there's always kind of these corporate options, but no one's ever become a superstar or, you know, a nationally recognized, I guess, artist without their engine. So.
Like, I don't need, we don't need all that. Give me the keys so I can push these packs to get these jeans.